Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. We just did a video previously on solving an equation introduction, and we didn't get all the way through it. The video was getting kind of long, so I'm restarting it. What makes an equation is an equal sign. Means to when you want to solve an equation, it means find out what the variable equals. Not every equation can be solved, but the ones that you're going to be given in the beginning will be solvable. Can there be more than one solution to an equation? Yes, but the ones that you're going to be given are going to have one solution for a while. That's something that you get into longer. We looked at solving by inspection, that is just looking at an equation and knowing how what the answer is just by looking at it. And then we said we needed methods because the equations will start to get tricky and you need a method in order to solve it. The method that we looked at first was an addition property of equality, and we solved several equations using that. And that brings us up to where we are now in this video. Notice that every time I solved an equation, I did the same thing to both sides. That's keeping that in balance. That's that scale that we need. So now let's look at the second one, the second property, and that's the multiplication property of equality. And we're going to use it. But first, we want to know what it is. So the multiplication property of equality says if A equals B, then AC equals BC. We can multiply both sides of the equation by something and it keeps it equal. So that's true. And also, we could multiply it by a fraction, which is really the same as dividing it. If we multiply both sides by c, or we multiply both sides by 1 over c, we also can get the same thing. So what that implies is that a over c is equal to b over c, because if we multiply straight across, remember there's like a little imaginary one under there. So we can multiply both sides by c, or we can divide both sides by c because of that property. So let's use it. So, and to start off, we're saying 4 times d equals 20. And we could solve that one by inspection, probably, or most of us could anyway. I think my camera's a little crookedy and it's bugging me, but this probably isn't a good time to fix that. And maybe that's better. And so, what we're saying is if 4 times d equals 20, what's 20? And the method we're going to use is the second part. We're going to say, well, our coefficient is d, and we always want our coefficient, our coefficient is 4. We always want our coefficient to be 1, and so we want to divide something by itself because 4 over 4 is not 0. It cancels to 1, and 1d, we can just write d. We don't need to write that coefficient of 1. 20 divided by 4 is 5, and now we can see, is that true? If we have 4 times 5, would that be 20? And of course, 20 equals 20, so that checks out. The solution to our equation means that we found out what d was. D was our variable. Now, in this case, I have 1/2 times t, and I can multiply both sides, I can divide both sides by 1/2, like I did here. What happens when you divide by 1/2? Well, when you divide by 1/2, it ends up multiplying by 2 over 1. Remember, we flip it and find the reciprocal. So when I have an equation that's got a fraction there, I have two ways to think about it, and we'll do both of those. I can think about it as dividing by 1/2. 1/2 over 1/2, anything divided by itself is always 1. So that just goes away. And then I have 6 divided by 1/2. 6 divided by 1/2 is 6 times 2 over 1, and that means t equals 12. That means half of 12 is 6. I think we can all believe that that's true. 6 equals 1/2 times 12. So I don't have to believe it, I can check it. And then I can go back here and do this another way, and that is 6 equals 1/2 t. But I know that dividing by 1/2 is the same as multiplying by 2 over 1, so let's just do that. 2 times 6 is 12, and the halves cancel, and that's t equals 12. So that's another way to do that, but a little simpler way. Okay, sorry that was going off the page there. Let's take a look at the last two that I have for you, and that is V over negative 2 is negative 10, and negative 7 equals 5z. While the first one, V is being divided by negative 2. So I want to get rid of that negative 2, and what I do is the opposite operation, which is multiplying by negative 2. You could think of it as negative 2 over 1, if that's helpful. And then you can go over here and say, I'm going to multiply by negative 2 over here, because again, it's always that balance that we're thinking about. Now, negative 2 over and negative 2, the signs have to be the same here. We're using the multiplicative identity, which says any number times its reciprocal equals 1. And so we want to make sure that we have exactly the same sign. And so we have those negative 2s go away. And negative 10 times negative 2 is positive 20. So we can check that. If positive 20 divided by negative 2 is really negative 10. Well, 20 divided by negative, a positive divided by a negative is negative 10. And so negative 10 equals negative 10, true, and V equals 20. Now I wanted to show you one where it doesn't come out to be a nice whole number or integer, and that is we have this one. We want to get rid of the coefficient. The coefficient in our equations always has to be 1. When we're finished, notice we have 1 t equals 12. We don't actually show that, but I could call that 1 t. Some instructors will have you write the 1, and I don't have you do it. It's okay if you do. I wouldn't take off for that, but the idea is this. You can always say 1 times something. If somebody says, how old are you, could say, I'm 1 times 25, but you don't need to, because 25 would suffice. So you don't need the 1, but it's okay if you have it. Okay, now I want to get rid of this coefficient. I always get rid of a coefficient by dividing it by itself. I'm going to divide both sides by 5, and that's going to give me, these 5s cancel not to 0, but to 1. So you have 1z, or just z. And then over here I have negative 7/5. Now here's where people want to start dividing out and getting mixed numbers or getting decimals. Just leave it. Improper fractions are perfectly acceptable, and I like them more than the other things, and so does the program that we use to do the homework with. So leave it as negative 7/5. That's a perfectly acceptable answer. And that is the basic use of the multiplication property. Sometimes we multiply and sometimes we divide. We multiplied here. I showed you a way to multiply here, but we divided here and here. So you're multiplying and dividing when you're talking about the multiplication property. Have a fantastic day.